All right, it is early February, and we are ready to set our raccoon traps. Normally, I would have set these out earlier in the year, maybe early January, but for whatever reason, it's just been kind of busy. If you can look over there, we've got a chicken coop, and this is a real problem for predators. We've had several raccoons, several foxes try to dig underneath the predator guard, so this is a perfect place to try to catch a raccoon. The reason why I trap is because I'm a turkey hunter, and I've noticed over the last probably 10-15 years our turkey population has really declined. So and I think that's a direct result of nest predators taking the eggs. And so what we're going to try to do is catch raccoons, possums, skunks in this cage trap. And then also these are Duke dog proof traps. These are specifically well for coons, but I've also caught a couple of possums in this as well. So today we're gonna set some traps. I've got just cheap cat food, some bacon grease and marshmallows, and then I've got some sardines, and probably Sam, our cat, he's smelling these sardines. I've already loaded this trap right here, and I'm just gonna show you how to load this. These style traps, they have a trigger, so it's specifically for animals that can grab. So the bait's gonna be below that trigger. He's gonna reach in there, and he's gonna try to pull it out, and then his wrist is gonna get caught. So let me try to show you how to load this. I've already loaded that one. This one has been sitting out for probably a couple years. I have a little tool that you can use, but a flathead screwdriver will work just as well. And so what we'll do is we'll just put the screwdriver head right there. Again, this one's been out. I can already tell it's the spring is a little, and we just work that a little bit like that. And we are going to put it on that little, there we go. And again, just set it like that. Okay, and so there's a, I should have cleaned it out a little bit first. There we go. So anyway, what I'm gonna do here is show you what it's, I'm not gonna set this one here, I'm gonna go in the woods and I'm gonna set this. But look, so this is set, so a raccoon, there's gonna be food in there. So pretend this is a raccoon foot. He's gonna reach around in there and boom. He's gonna catch his paw. He's not gonna be able to get out. So that's how to set that trap. I've got it connected to this pole right here. So it's not gonna go anywhere. The raccoon will you know, not be able to bring it up over this 4-foot pole. So we're good to go. And I put a can underneath, over the top of my trap, just so a cat or anything that I don't want to catch is not gonna come bother the trap. And also it keeps the rain out, and you just won't wash away the bacon grease or the marshmallow or the cat food. So I'm gonna put that over there. It actually is probably a sign. I mean, the raccoon coming down this little trail right here, he sees this cup, he smells it, he's gonna be able to lift that up off of that. And this little kitty cat will not be able to lift it because she's not smart enough, are you, Inky? All right, so we're gonna put that there. Hopefully tonight we're gonna catch one. And let's set this one right here. We're gonna set it just a few feet from this trap. And what you wanna do with these cage traps is find a relatively flat spot. I'm gonna get all of the debris out from under it. You don't want that anything in the way of that that little pan right there, the trigger. And I like to actually put something pretty heavy on it just in case a raccoon comes and he might, you know, try to knock it over. So I put a couple of blocks on it like that, and then I'm gonna actually, this sardine, I'm gonna actually, I just opened it up like this and actually put it closed up like this, but they can still smell it. And this one again has been setting out all year, and so it's a little hard to set, but I'm gonna show you how to do this. So there's this little trigger right here. There we go. What's gonna happen is a raccoon or a possum or skunk or even a cat can come in here. I've caught cats in here before, but you can easily release them. And they're gonna go in there. Again, we're gonna put some bait around here, like this. even sprinkle some out a little bit. And I want some sardine juice like this. And I might even put some marshmallows. Let the raccoon, you know, put some marshmallows back there. And so he's gonna have some bait. I'm gonna actually put the bait back there in a second, but he's gonna walk in there and trip this right here, put his weight on there, and boom, he's caught. There's nothing he can do, okay? So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put the sardines back there, the very back, see that? Put some of these cat food back there. He's gonna really be after that sardine. I'm gonna take this bacon grease, and what raccoon or anything doesn't like bacon grease? You see that? I'm just gonna throw it back there, make sure it's not in the way of that trigger. Put it right there. So he's got bacon, he's got sardines, and he's got cat food. And so right now we're gonna set it. Now Inky, we do not wanna catch you, okay? Okay, so make sure, what I usually do is just make sure there's nothing underneath that trap. Where'd my screwdriver go? Callie, can you hand me my screwdriver, babe? And then I'm just going to make sure there's nothing under there that could cause it to not go all the way down. It looks good, okay? So what's gonna happen is that raccoon is gonna come in there and put a little bit on this side right here, a little bit of this side. And I'm gonna actually, we've got some, again, bacon grease on there. Let's just put some of that bacon grease right there. And we are good to go. We've got a live trap, have a heart trap, and we've got a dog-proof trap. Hopefully we're gonna catch a couple of coons tonight. And that'll be one or two less turkey nest predators that we have to worry about this spring. All right, let's go set one up there in the woods and I'll show you that setup.
But Daddy, you can't post this until you get a raccoon.
Yeah,
now.
I know, yeah. All right. Okay, so Collie and I and Kenley have set a couple of traps. I just wanted to show you something. I've got my trail camera here. And this is a really good trail camera, and it's got video mode on it. So we're gonna actually be able to see, you know, a lot of times you'll have a trigger that's fired and you don't catch anything. Not many times, but sometimes you will on these dog proof, but most of the time, probably 95%, you'll catch something. But a lot of times these have heart traps, they fail. So this video is gonna tell me exactly what's happening. So if I get something, if I get a raccoon or a possum and they're, you know, reaching through or something, or, you know, hitting the pan with their paws, then I'll, you know that I need to do something a little bit different. But so hopefully, you know, the video camera is gonna help us see what's coming around here. And then, cause we have been getting a lot of predators. I don't know if there's raccoons or possums or, Kylie, we have seen a red fox down here, even in the, yes, in the middle of the day. Tell them about the red fox that we saw.
So, this red fox has been coming around here and digging up over here near the chain coop.
Mm-hmm.
So, Van had to put cement.
Who's Van?
You!
Your daddy?
Yes.
Yeah.
So he had to put cement here. He even carved our last name in it.
Yeah. Well, they're actually, there's predator guard. There's this welded wire that goes actually about 18 inches through here, and I've got it pinned down. So there's no way a predator is going to be able to get underneath here, but we have had some, you know, trying to dig. We've got 7 chickens now, and looking forward to protecting them, and then also catching some turkey nest predators, right, Kylie? Because we are turkey hunters, aren't we? Have we got any? Uh-oh. What do we got here? Who's that? Is that Aunt Bee?
I can't tell if
Aunt
this
B,
is
do you
Aunt
have an
Bee
egg in there?
Or Sunny. Oh, this is Aunt Bee.
Does she have an egg?
Do you?
Let's see if you got an egg.
She has an egg. He has a fresh egg.
Fresh egg, yep. All right, well, you sit on that for a while and we'll come back and get it.
Thank you, Aunt Bee.
Thank you, Aunt Bee. Okay, guys, let's go up in the woods where we're going to place a couple of these dog-proof traps and see if we can catch several coons or possums or whatever's going to try to grab the bait. This is our
food plot, didn't we, girls, where we deer hunt and turkey hunt. Got some wheat here, clover. Been really feeding the deer this past January. This past month has been really cold and snowy. And I've gotten a lot of pictures of deer up here. You can see where there's still, look at this active scrape right here. It's February the, I think, 6th. And a deer's been working that scrape right there. All right, guys, let's go back here. Scrape right there. Early February and they're still got some scraping action going on. What do you think about that?
I'm really happy.
This is where the turkeys like to roost. They like to roost up in these oaks and these elms and maples. So I'm gonna try to catch a raccoon. All right, guys, we're back here in the woods, probably about 150 yards from where we've got our chicken coop and other traps set up. And we're on an old logging road. Kylie, just let him see that logging road right there. So this is where I get a lot of pictures. I've got a mock scrape right there. And during the year, I get tons of raccoons coming through here. So this is where I've got this set up right here. So we've got it tied to this tree. And again, I won't show you how to set it. Did I not bring my screwdriver?
I don't think.
We're in trouble, guys. I'm gonna see if I got enough. Look at that. I'm not powerful enough. Kenley, you going to get it? Kylie's already showing us how to throw it within the path. Raccoon's coming down here. He's gonna smell that there's cat food or something there for him to eat, free meal. And then he's gonna smell the concentration of it right here. And then this is when he's gonna love it. He's gonna think he's got free supper. All right, it's the morning after we've set the trap, and I heard the chickens carrying on a little bit worse than normal. They usually make a lot of noise. Looked out the window, and in the cage trap, we have a nest predator. And Kylie, what is that nest predator?
A skunk.
A skunk, a stinky skunk. So I'm gonna go ahead and dispatch this skunk before Sam gets over there and gets sprayed. All right, Kylie and I have just driven back to the woods to check on our second trap that we set yesterday, and it has been sprung. Something has tripped it. We've got the red cup out in the middle of the trail. It's been knocked over, and I can see something moving on the other side of that log. Kylie, let's go check out and see what it is. All right, here you go, Kylie. All right, let's go check it out. It's the dog proof that we've got. So Kylie, walk up really slow, kind of behind it, and see if you can tell what it is.
Hold on, let me follow it close. Let me go ahead and can you see what it is?
No, not yet. Looks like it's been scratching around in the leaves. Yeah. The leaves are covering it. Let's see.
Stay right there. Come up the top. Looks like it's a possum. Looks like it's a possum.
Ooh. See that?
Yes.
Two out of the three traps have been sprung. And so we've gotten two nest predators out of the population. Hopefully we'll start trapping some raccoons. But for our first day, this is very good. Very good news. So Kylie, we did a good job, okay? Let's go ahead and dispatch this one, and then we'll reset the trap, okay?
Okay.
All right, Kylie, again, it's the day after we set these traps. We've caught a possum, it's a female, and then we've got a skunk down there in the cage trap. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna reset this trap, same area, and I've actually got another dog-proof trap that I'm gonna set maybe about 20 yards up the hill a little bit on the same path. This seems to be a really, really good spot for critters, especially on these cold nights, and I think we're going to probably catch several more, aren't we, Kylie?
Close feet,
so let's go ahead and
reset this. We're gonna use peanut butter this time with some cat food and marshmallows and some bacon grease. So should really draw them in. And again, it's still early February. We've got another 3.5 weeks to trap before turkey season. So let's get this thing set and get out of here.
Okay, so we've set that other trap probably about 50 yards up the hill. So we're gonna set this one again with marshmallows. These things are rock hard. Normally you want these a little bit softer, but we're gonna push that below the trigger, so it doesn't matter. Push it down there, below the trigger. We're gonna put peanut butter mixed with some cat food. We won't be able to resist that. Got meats and treats. Or meats and sweets. So a little bit of bacon grease out here. So we got bacon grease, cat food. Don't have any more sardines. I'm gonna have to go to the store and get some more, but anyway, I think we'll be able to resist that. Just put that marshmallow down below that trigger. And throw some of these out and put some more. Okay, again, I'm gonna use it's just a bite cable. And just you want it at least on probably a 3 to 4 inch tree. And one where they can't climb. So this will be good. So what we're gonna do is just set that there. And then I've just got a little carabiner here. Put that in there, make sure this is tight. Raccoons, they're really smart critters. They can actually twist that off. So anyway, we're gonna set this one. Again, this one's been in the garage for a long time. It's probably a little tight. I'll do this, loosen the spring a little bit. Set this one, just like we did the others. I'm gonna put that out on the path a little bit. Like that. We'll sprinkle some cat food. Put this red cup again, that keeps the food dry. And then also provides a visual. They're coming down the trail and they see this red cup and they're curious. So they're gonna say, hey, what's in here? They're gonna smell the bait. Lift that up. You can see that the possum lifted that right up and got his wrist caught. So we're on the way to trapping a lot of nest predators this spring, Kylie.
Mm-hmm.
So we should have a good turkey hatch this year.
Hopefully.
And then also another hint. I just kind of cover this up with the leaves like this. Probably doesn't matter. They're used to seeing stuff like this all the time in the woods. So, but I cover pretty much everything up except for the trap. And then good to go.
Okay, so I dispatched the skunk and the possum up in the woods trap, and now I'm going to reset this one. I think this is a little too close to this one because if we caught something in the dog-proof trap, it could easily get tangled up or mess with the cage trap. So I'm going to move this one down a little bit closer to the chicken coop and then reset it.
Okay, so we've got the skunk in the trap. I'm just going to release it, and it does stink. You can shoot a skunk in the lungs and he's not going to spray, or he's not supposed to spray as much, but I like a clean headshot just to dispatch him, you know, humanely and quickly. But they do stink, and right now he is reeking. So hopefully I've let him, he's been dead for about an hour. So, man. Ah. Nasty. And never pick them up by the tail, because they're gonna, so you can see that he's got the pan all messed up, so we're gonna have to dig that out, clean that up. Again, gotta make sure that nothing's under that pan or it's gonna affect the way it triggers and releases. I think that's got everything underneath it. So I'm gonna actually put this down here a little bit, still flat. Still on the trail.
So one thing I forgot to mention yesterday is it's good to put the bait in a steel can and then put this behind the pan. And that way it keeps the food dry in case it rains. And then also it makes the critter actually kind of have to work for it. And he's moving his feet a little bit, and it's gonna trip that pan a lot quicker and won't have any misfires. So I'm gonna go ahead and set this again. We've got bacon grease, marshmallows, and cat food. So I'm just gonna put maybe a marshmallow. Put some of that good peanut butter in there. And so you got all of that in the back of the can like that. I'm gonna drop that in the back of the trap like that. I'm gonna set it. Again, this is an old trap, so it's you gotta have to kind of play with it a little bit, but that's good. And we're gonna put the blocks on it so nothing can turn it over. And then we are ready to catch another critter. Again, I don't, on these sardines, I just barely open them up. So that skunk wasn't able to open up the sardine can. So we're gonna throw it back there. One other thing I forgot to mention yesterday is you don't really want to put the bait right underneath this door, because they could be eating it and hit that door and cause it to misfire. So I'm just gonna actually put the bait out a couple of feet along the path. Again, they're gonna smell that on these cold nights. They're searching for food, meats and sweets, and we've got both of them covered. So we're gonna probably catch another one tonight. All right.
It's the second day that I've had the traps out, and I'm checking the woods trap. The coop trap didn't have anything in it, neither the cage nor the little dog proof, but I can see something that looks like a raccoon in this Duke dog proof in the woods right here. So let's go take a look. Looks like a raccoon. All right, buddy. I hate to do this, but got to take out some nest predators, okay? Oh, wow. Looks like we have another raccoon, guys. Okay, so I just dispatched the one by the food plot on this logging road, and I'm walking down, and there's another coon in the one that I set yesterday. So in less than 48 hours, I've caught two coons, a skunk, and a possum. So that just goes to show you, I mean, I trap every year, and I trap probably 10 or 12 nest predators in a month and a half's time. And it just goes to show you how they move in or displace the ones that have been killed. So it's just a constant thing that you need to do is trap these nest predators, get your neighbors to trap, and just so we can help that turkey population. Now, I understand that there's other factors that that are involved with the reduction of the turkey population. Habitat loss is definitely one. And there's some other factors as well, but definitely these nest predators are taking the eggs and just the poults. There's not enough poults surviving to sustain the population. And here in Tennessee, they've reduced the number of gobblers that you can take, which is probably a good thing until we get the numbers back up. But again, do your part and catch these nest predators. All right, so let me take care of this guy. All right, buddy. Just hang on, buddy. Hate to do this.
All All right, it's been less than 48 hours since we set the initial traps, less than 24 hours since I set this trap right here. In those 48 hours, I've caught two coons. These two are males. Looks like maybe one of the males is probably a year old. The other one is a mature male. And then caught a skunk and a possum yesterday. So four critters, nest predators, in less than 48 hours.
Okay, it's the afternoon of February the 11th. I think this is day three since we've set the traps. So far I've caught two coons, a skunk and a possum. And I'm back here checking the woods trap. And it looks like we have something in it. I can't tell, the leaves are all rustled, so let's go see. There he is, it's a possum. Alright, so I'm gonna take care of that. That was a possum in that trap, and I can see that I've got yet another animal in my woods trap, the other one I have up here, so let's go see. I think it's another possum.
All right, so after 3.5 days of trapping, we've got six nest predators that are no longer going to be a threat to the turkey population. You know, basically what we're doing in trapping is we're taking the life of one animal to save the life of dozens. So we're taking the life of a possum or taking the life of a coon to save potentially dozens of turkey poults for the future generation. And so I just encourage you guys, just as we've seen over the last 10-15 years, the turkey population is just dive bombed, really. And I think it's, of course, we've got habitat loss, but again, I think there's a direct correlation because there's not as many trappers out there. And so we just need to do our part as hunters, as conservationists, to trap some of these nest predators, again, to balance that prey predator population, so we can have you know, more turkeys in the future. And again, I hate to take an animal's life, even when I'm hunting. I hate the fact that I have to shoot something, but as a hunter, as a conservationist, that's what we do. I enjoy to eat wild game. I enjoy to give it to friends. I enjoy the thrill of the chase. And trapping is just another thing that we have to do. Yes, we're killing an animal, but we're saving the lives of dozens of turkeys. So again, hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, just make sure you give it a thumbs up, and please subscribe to my channel. And I was gonna actually catalog like 2 weeks of this, of trapping, but I think I've got enough to put together a decent video. So I hope you guys enjoyed.